Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how to create beautiful text like this in Pages and Keynote. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great community of supporters. Join us and get exclusive content at MACMOST.com/Patreon. Now to make this, we need the latest version of Keynote or Pages. It's Keynote 9.1, Pages 8.1. I'm going to use Keynote because it's a little easier to do graphics like this in Keynote. So I'm going to start with a standard template, white background, and then I'm going to select the default text that's there and remove it. I'm going to also zoom out a bit so I can see the full frame. And then I'm going to start by adding text. So I'll just click the text button at the top here. Then I'm going to type the word that will be nice and bold in the middle. And I'm going to select it all, Command A. And let's change the font. I like Helvetica New for this. But I'm going to go to condensed black. I'm going to make it nice and big. So 200 point. I want a font that's nice and thick so the image can fit inside of it. A thin font, of course, won't work very well for this. Now that I've got that, I'm going to set the text color. This is a new feature in Pages and Keynote in the last versions. And I'm going to go to Image Fill. And it's going to give me this default gray pattern here. I'm going to replace that with an image by dragging and dropping a JPEG from the Finder, from a regular Finder window into here. I could also use that Choose button and we'll drop it in. And already we're in business. We have a nice image here and the text looks great. Notice I'm using Scale to Fill, which is perfect for this. And I'm going to continue by clicking on the Advanced Options button here. And this will allow me to add an outline. And I'm going to change the outline color to white. I'm going to increase it to 5 pixels, a nice thick white outline. Then I'm going to add a shadow, and the shadow I'm going to increase the offset to something like 10 points. I'm going to change the angle so it's shadowing on the bottom right there. A little bit more of a blur to it. And then I'm going to add a background on this. So I'll click out there and I can see what I've got so far. I'm going to use shape, select a square, and I've got this square here. I'm going to drag it out of the way. And then go to Arrange, Send to Back. So now it's behind the letters. So now I can stretch this. And I'm going to stretch it so it's beyond the edge of the screen. And I'll explain why later. And I'm going to stretch it so it goes just above and below the letters there, like that. Change it to a bit of a darker blue. And next thing I want to do is I really want to have the letters kind of pop out a little bit. So I'm going to have just the first letter here be larger. So I'm going to select just the C and I'm going to change its font size to 280. Now it's going to pop out of the top there because it's going to align the baseline here at the bottom. So I'm going to go to Advanced Settings again and I'm going to do a baseline shift so I can move it up or down. I'm going to move it down at 20 pixels, maybe a little bit more, just so it looks like it's kind of centered still on those. So you can see now how the C pops up and below the bar. So now I can adjust this so the rest of the letters are inside and the C goes above and below. So I like how that looks. Now I'm going to angle it. So I'm going to select the background and shift select the text so I have both selected. And I can go to Arrange and there's a rotate setting here. I'm going to do an angle of 10 degrees. And now you can see why I needed this bar to go beyond the edges here because when I set it at an angle I would have some of the edge here, the corner showing. So I like how this looks. Let's do something with the background here. I can go and click on the background and go to Format and there's Color Fill and I can select it to say an orange background like that. I'll add more text and the Colorful Colorado. I'll select that. I'll make that nice and big as well. I'll also make it the same font. I'll change the text color as well. I'll select that same blue. I'll set an outline here as well. I'll make that white, not quite as big, about 3 pixels to fit the size of this font here. I'm going to option drag it to make a copy. Then here I'm going to make this a little smaller. And I'm going to position this here at the bottom right corner and this at the top. So I think that's pretty decent looking. I can hit the play button because this is Keynote. It's going to think this is a slideshow and that gives me this full screen view of it. So I get a good idea of what it looks like with the edges cut off and everything. Now there's more I can do. I can have a different image for every letter. So I'll leave the C alone, but I will select the O. And I'll drag another image into here. So I'll just drag this one in here. And I've got one in there. And I'll do that for each letter. I can add an image to the background as well. So I'm going to drag an image here and just put it in as a normal image that will fill the space. I'm going to select it and I'm going to arrange it and send it back. It's a little overwhelming, so one trick I like to do is do another shape here. And I'll just take this square. I'll set that to fill everything. And I will send that to the back, but then I will bring it forward one. So not bring to front, but bring forward. Then I'll take this, I'll set its style to white and change how opaque it is here so the text still stands out. And I can get something like this. We could see how that looks by hitting the play button as well. I think I kind of like this one a little bit better. Whatever you end up with, you've got lots of options now. You can go to File, Export To, and Export an Image. And you can use that image, say, posting it online. You can use it in a document. You can use it in a video as well. Now what you can't do is you can't curve the letters. You can't make the letters pop out like 3D. And you can't do a lot of different things with the text that you can do in more advanced apps like, say, Photoshop or Illustrator or something. But this was quick and easy to do and it didn't take any additional software. Plus, since this is in Keynote, I could actually build this over a series of frames and then have it animate. So have each thing draw and pop up on the screen. And that can make for a really interesting opening sequence for a video. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.